Hey folks, this is Cynde Whitlow. Thanks so much for stopping by. I am so excited to be here today for Spellbinders, and for my project today, I'm going to be using the Bird on Cherry Branch Etched Die Set, also Botanical Butterfly Etched Die Set, as well as the Floral Panel Card Etched Die Set. So the cards I'm sharing with you today are really easy to put together. In fact, you could probably mass produce these fairly well. I couldn't decide which colors I wanted to use, so I decided to make two of them. I love these little flowers in red, and the color turquoise always goes great with red. Okay, so I initially thought that I would do these cards in black, and I ended up changing my mind, but I wanted to show you this. So I want to make a shape card, and I'm using the Floral Panel Card Frame die, and I have a top folding note card. It was cut at 4 1/4 inches by 11 inches and scored at 5 1/2, and I have that top edge of the die just over the top of my fold on my panel, and I'm going to run that through my die cut machine. And then I also cut out two other panels. This is Nina Solar White cardstock of just the full panel with that large frame die. And then I also had cut that little butterfly out with some gold foil cardstock, and I'm just placing that here on my card panel, and I'm kind of drawing myself a couple little lines there because I'm actually going to take this distressed pattern stamp, and I'm going to be doing some heat embossing on the front of my card panel, and I needed to kind of give myself an idea of where I wanted to stamp this. I'm inking up my stamp with Versamark ink, and I did treat both of these panels with anti-static powder before I did this because I am going to be using some gold embossing powder, and I didn't want any of that gold embossing powder to stick where I didn't want it to. So the stamp is too long for the panel, and I want the ends of that image to kind of taper off. I don't want any blunt lines on that. So one end is fine because that's how the stamp is designed, but the other end is going to be really solid and it's going to be really blunt. So in order to fix that, I'm just going to take a dry paintbrush. It's just a paintbrush I have here in my stash, and I'm going to wipe some of that off. Now I do get a little overzealous here as I'm wiping this off, and I wipe off a little too much, but that's okay. That Versamark ink is still wet enough that I can simply add more powder to it and then try it again. And honestly, you could probably just leave this, those lines, just the way they are. You probably don't need to do this, but it was kind of important to me that I fix this and make sure that it kind of tapered off a little bit because I could notice it. But if that doesn't bother you, then totally leave it. It's just fine. Now, I do have my heat gun heating up while I'm doing this because I want to make sure that it's nice and hot. I'm going to try to minimize as much warping as I possibly can because this panel isn't going to be popped up or anything. I'm not going to have any foam behind it or anything to help keep it straight. So I want to minimize that warping as much as possible. Now, I have that butterfly back there on my panel. I do not have it stuck down because I'm going to keep moving it. I am using gold delicata ink. You could probably heat emboss these as well, but I just decided to pull out my delicata ink and stamp these instead. And you probably just noticed that I totally just dropped my stamp right after I'd inked it up. Fortunately, it landed in such a way that I can totally fake this. Here in a moment, I'm going to stamp it up there in the top right-hand corner and make it look like I absolutely did that on purpose, even though that I didn't, because I am not starting this card over. So I'm just going to finish stamping these in there. I am kind of making this a little bit manufactured while I'm trying to make it look like I totally just splattered paint all over it. And you could do that. You could absolutely take some gold paint and splatter it over the top of your card panel and it would look awesome. But I wanted to be able to control this just a little bit more. Plus, I really enjoy these distressed stamps. So I'm just going to speed this up real quick and show you how I finish stamping all of this on there. I do end up taking that largest distress stamp and just going back behind where that butterfly is going to sit so that peeks through those wings. Now I do have some foam tape on the back side of my butterfly here. I have a couple layers build up because I want to make sure that I have plenty of dimension here, and then also so this doesn't get crushed later. And then I also attached the base of that with some adhesive as well as the tips of those wings. You could totally leave the tips of those wings. You wouldn't have to secure those to your card. I did because I liked the idea of this gold foil cardstock being curved back and attached to my card. So now I'm going to attach the body of the butterfly. This actually cuts out in a much larger piece, and then you score it down the middle and fold it in half. I do have a piece of dimensional foam tape on the inside there to pop it up a little bit, but you could just simply fold this in half and adhere it to your card, and that would be just fine, but I'm really playing up all of this dimension. I also used a piece of double-sided adhesive to attach that to the butterfly wing. That gold foil cardstock doesn't stick to itself very well with most adhesives, but that double-sided adhesive works great. Now I'm going to attach the antenna for this little butterfly, and honestly, folks, I don't know if I actually did this right. I think you can actually just use one of these and that would be just fine, but I really like the idea of two of them, and I felt like it added a little bit more character to the overall design. But I think I got these on there backwards. I'm not entirely certain, but I was just gonna go with it because I thought it looked fine anyway. So I'm using more adhesive to just kind of stick those temporarily. Now again, that liquid adhesive doesn't work super great on this gold foil cardstock, and that's okay. I just essentially wanted to be able to hold them together long enough to tuck them up underneath the little body of that butterfly. And then I'm going to add a little bit more glue and make sure that everything sticks for the long term. All right, so now we're going to start working on these flowers. And I die cut these, some of the flowers from the Bird on Cherry Branch die set from red cardstock and blue-green cardstock. I also cut the leaves in from the same die set from green cardstock, and then there is a little kind of a leafy piece in that floral card panel die set that I cut out of green cardstock as well. I just cut that out in a slightly darker color. I am taking some Copics and I am adding a little bit of a detail to these. All of these die cuts, you don't have to do that. You could totally skip this part if you wanted to. I just felt it added a little bit more character. And on this little, these little green leaves, I'm using a YG17 and I'm adding in just a little bit of shadow. And then I'm going to blend that out with a YG03. This actually goes pretty quick, but again, if you don't feel like you want to do any of that, then go ahead and skip it. It's fine. For the blue-green flowers, I am using a BG49, and I'm just kind of sketching in a little bit of shadow, a little bit of dimension. Nothing too exciting. It's actually kind of sloppy. And then I'm going to blend that out a little bit with a BG45. Now, that BG45 actually matches this blue-green cardstock pretty well. And then also what's going to happen as this dries back, as the alcohol in the marker starts to evaporate on this cardstock here, it's actually going to dry back quite a bit, and this is going to lighten up quite a bit. Now those red flowers, I ended up using an R39 on those. Even as dark as that normally is on white cardstock, by the time it dried back, you actually couldn't tell, and then I decided to totally skip it. So now I have my Spellbinders embossing mat, and I have a stylus here, and I'm taking the ball of that stylus, and I'm literally just going in circles while I press down. Now this embossing mat is perfect for this because it helps give that flower a little bit of give with the ball of that stylus, and it helps the petals pop up. To finish adding a little bit more detail to those, I'm just taking the end of my little tool here and I'm simply wrapping those around that. It's super easy. Now I want to add a little bit more dimension to these flowers, so I'm taking some more foam tape and I'm just putting it in between the two layers of these flowers. And then I'm going to leave those at that for the time being. Now, here's a little trick for these itty bitty little leaves. Hold the leaf, the darkest end, your shadow end, in one hand and pretty much press your fingernail into it. Now, you don't want to crease it, but just press your fingernail into it. Now, take the tip of that leaf and just simply wrap it around your little pick. Anything, a toothpick would work fine if you don't have a craft pick to work with. And that's it. That's all there is to those. After I have all of these put together, I'm going to start adhering them to my card base. Now, this is the point where I had decided I was not going to use black. I had actually had done these cards and on black cardstock, changed my mind, started over with the white. So I had to pull these off the black cardstock. So some of my flowers and leaves still stayed attached when I pulled those off, and that's just fine. You're still going to see exactly what I was trying to accomplish here. You could, at this point, you could really build these up. If you wanted to do all sorts of different kinds of colors on the front of this card, you could totally do that. I would keep it to, I don't know, probably about five flowers. I wouldn't do any more than that, but you could totally build this up. Now, I only did three for each card because I was trying to keep it pretty quick and pretty simple, but you could absolutely build it up and it would just be gorgeous. I also think that these flowers would be really cool in a vellum. You totally wouldn't have to do these in color. Vellum would be gorgeous. So I'm just kind of building these up around the bottom of my little butterfly here, and I'm just tucking them in, making sure that I have lots and lots of glue on the backside of each of those die cuts because I want to make sure that they're not going to go anywhere. The one thing that I didn't show you, because I had done this before when I had worked on the black cards, was I added some little pearls to the center of those flowers. I think gemstones would be cool. If you have any Nuvo crystal drops, those would be cool. Stardust stickles would be awesome. You could put anything you wanted in the center of those. If you had brads, you could do that as well, and it would also be really cool. Now, this is kind of what I was talking about, how that gold foil cardstock, it doesn't take well to adhesives, so that one kind of popped off. It hadn't been stuck on there long enough to really attach itself, so I did put a little bit more glue on there and put it back on there. And I'm just going to finish tucking these little guys in there. And I'm just trying to build this up. I don't want to cover up too much of that butterfly because he's really the star of our show here. But I do want to kind of build up enough around him that it looks like I have a little bit of balance. I'm really sorry. My head is in the way, folks. I really had to get over the top of this a few times and see exactly what I was doing there. Now, while I was working on the red card, I was actually building the blue-green card as well. Since I had everything out, I figured the quickest way to do this was assembly line style, and it worked out great. These cards went together really fast. I would say altogether, I probably put in about half an hour, 35 minutes for both cards. So at this point, you could leave this card as it is. It would be just fine. You could put it on your card base and call it a day. I, however, cannot leave well enough alone. So I decided to put a sentiment on the front of this. And I really love how the stamp set paired well with that butterfly. I think it looks amazing. Now, it says love you, and it's completely attached. You could cut this apart, but I can't. I can't bring myself to cut my stamps apart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mask off the you part and I'm going to stamp the love part. Now, I already have all of this built up on the front of my card panel, so I do need to keep that in mind. But that's okay. This is still totally doable. I started out with one color or one type of black ink, and then I realized that this wasn't going to be dark enough, and I get one shot at this. So I actually reached for another black ink that I knew was going to be dark and crisp enough, and I stamped that on there. Now I am going to make sure that my stamp is good and clean before I ink it up again. So I'm giving it a good scrub with a baby wipe. I wipe that off really good so everything is nice and dry. And then I'm going to place that labeling tape back over the love portion of the stamp this time and just ink up the U side of it. Now do make sure that you pull off that masking tape before you stamp it, folks, or it's going to be a sad day. I also make sure that I clean off my block really good because I don't want that touching anything else that is on my card panel. So to finish this off, I am going to add just a few more pearls to this. These are the same pearls that I used on the inside of those flowers. It just kind of helps tie everything in so it looks cohesive. And then I'm going to attach these card panels to my card base. I have some double-sided tape that I am putting on this. You could use any adhesive you like, but I like this double-sided tape. I know that it's always nice and secure. Now normally when I add my card panel to my card base, I always start at the top. On shaped cards like this, because the top of the card panel and the top of the card base are not the same shape, you actually need to start from the bottom. And I make sure everything is lined up. I look at both corners and the bottom edge. As soon as those are lined up, I can just lay it down perfectly flat and it lines up perfect every time. So that is it. We're done, folks. I really enjoy how these turned out. These dies are amazing. They have so much detail and they're so beautiful. I think that these would also look really great in a watercolor, or you could absolutely Copic color these. I think a vellum would be super cool too. You could also do some dry embossing with these on a card panel, and that would also be fun. There is also the Botanical Dragonfly and the Flower Garden collection that I also think would be super fun, and I look forward to using that here in the future. But for now, we are done. We are good to go. I hope you enjoyed my card today. If you did, hit that like button and also be sure to share it with your friends. Thanks again so much for stopping by. Until next time.